In this slide, let's look at the encoding and modulation signal processing techniques that are used in DSL technologies. Various popular methods of encoding and modulation techniques are QAM, pulse code modulation, pulse amplitude modulation, V.90, carrierless amplitude and phase modulation, discrete multitone modulation, and so on. The common ones are QAM, V.90, CAP, and DMT. In this section, CAP and DMT are summarized. Figure shows the spectral use of CAP, that is carrierless amplitude and phase modulation. What is carrierless amplitude phase modulation? It is a modulation similar to QAM but is more complex than QAM. Both CAP and QAM are single carrier signal techniques. CAP is a non-standard variation of QAM. How is QAM produced? QAM amplitude modulates two carrier waves which have 90 degrees phase shift between them. Whereas, CAP generates QAM signal by combining two PAM signals filtered through two filters. This is a non-standard version of QAM. CAP in ADSL divides available space into three bands, 0 to 4 kHz for telephone voice, 25 to 160 kHz for upstream traffic, and 240 to 1.5 MHz for downstream traffic. CAP is obsolete now, and a new technology called DMT has completely replaced this in ADSL. CAP is a multi-level, multi-phase encoding method. CAP algorithm represents the data bit combinations in a form which consists of variations in amplitude and phase. Therefore, CAP creates a number of signals to be sent over the twisted pair lines. Unlike the DMT, CAP uses a whole frequency range from 4 kHz to 1.1 MHz as a single channel. More the number of bits to be transmitted, more will be the number of signals that the CAP generates. The main advantages of CAP, of course, are low cost, lower latency, and rate adaptability. Meanwhile, DMT is considered a more reliable and a more sophisticated technology. In this slide, let's look at ADSL's another popular modulation technique known as DMT, Discrete Multitone Modulation. PSTN utilizes a small bandwidth of just 300 to 3400 Hz to carry voice signals. However, the copper lines to your home can carry a frequency spectrum of typically 1.1 MHz for data communication. DMT utilizes fully this entire frequency spectrum. Look at the DMT spectrum in the figures that are given here. The basic idea of DMT is to split the available bandwidth into a larger number of sub-channels. The sub-channels are divided into groups, one for upstream and one for downstream. In ADSL, downstream group is divided into 256 frequency bands or channels or 256 4 kHz wide tones, that is 1024 kHz. The available 1.1 MHz spectrum on the local loop is divided into 256 independent channels of 4312.5 Hz each. Channel 0 is used for parts. Channel 1 to 5 are not used to keep the voice signal and the data signals from interfering with each other. That is a kind of guard band. Of the remaining 250 channels, one is used for upstream control and one is used for downstream control. The rest 248 channels are available for user data. The upstream group is divided into 32 sub-channels, 140 kHz approximately. Each sub-channel is independent and has its own stream of signals. Please note that ADSL does not affect parts in any way. The lower 4 kHz part is reserved for parts and is filtered by the splitter. So the voice and data signals can be separated and thus phone calls can be made at the same time when ADSL data service is being used. ADSL uses DMT encoding methods which use QAM extensively. QAM compression ratio is 15 bits per baud. With 224 downstream channels, download speed can be 13.44 Mbps, which is theoretical. In practice, signal-to-noise ratio is never good enough to achieve this rate, but typically 8 Mbps is possible on short runs over high-quality local loops. The ADSL standard, ANSI T.413, ITU G.992.1, allows speeds as much as 8 Mbps downstream and 1 Mbps upstream. However, few providers offer this kind of speed. Typically, providers offer 512 kbps downstream and 64 kilobits upstream standard service, or 1 Mbps downstream and 256 kbps upstream, which is a premium service. In this slide, let's look at the implementation of DMT. You can imagine the system as though your copper line is divided into 224 different 4 kilowatts lines from your service provider's end to your home all the way, and each line is having one modem attached to it at each end. At a macro level, downstream 224 and upstream 32 channels are assumed. Therefore, you get the equivalent of 224 modems connected to your computer in the downstream at once simultaneously. Each channel is monitored, and if the quality is unacceptable, the signal is moved to another channel. The system constantly shifts signals between different channels, searching for the best channels. In addition, some of the lower channels, those starting at about 8 kHz, are used as bidirectional channels for both upstream and downstream. Monitoring and sorting out the information on the bidirectional channels and keeping up with the quality of all these 248 channels makes DMT more complex to implement than CAP, but gives more flexibility on lines of differing quality standards. Look at the figure where an implementation is shown. DMT combines QAM and FDM. The output of each channel is 4 kHz. Compression through QAM is 15:1. Therefore, if you work backwards, the input to each of these QAM channels is 60 kilobits per second. The ANSI standard defines a rate of 60 kilobits per second for each 4 kHz channel, which means a QAM combination with 15 bits per baud is utilized. There are 224 downlink channels. Therefore, the input data stream theoretically can be 60 kilobits into 224, which will be 13.44 Mbps. In practice, signal-to-noise ratio is never good enough to achieve this rate, but 8 Mbps is typically possible on short runs over high-quality local loops. This is a basic implementation of a DMT. For further details, you may refer to our advanced courses.